Hello everyone. In this chapter, alcohols, phenols and ethers, today in this video I'll be talking about the reaction of alcohols due to the breaking of CO bond, or you can say the bond in between carbon and oxygen, and the reactions of phenols. Reaction due to breaking of CO bond is alcohols. The first reaction we'll be talking about, reaction of alcohol with hydrogen halides. You already know, among hydrogen halides, HI is the most reactive, then HBr is less than HI and HCl is the least. Alcohol react with hydrogen halides to form alkyl halides, and the reactivity of alcohol is tertiary is the most, then secondary, and then the primary alcohol. Simply, HCl will react with alcohol in presence of anhydrous zinc chloride to give you alkyl chloride along with the formation of water. Then, if you talk about the reaction of alcohol with phosphorus halide, if the reaction is happening in between alcohol and phosphorus trihalide, we'll be getting alkyl halide and phosphorus acid. And if the reaction is happening in between phosphorus pentachloride with any alcohol, you will be getting alkyl chloride, hydrogen chloride and phosphorus oxychloride as the products. Now, next reaction is dehydration of alcohols. Dehydration of alcohols used to happen in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid or phosphoric acid or alumina, which is Al2O3. Alcohols undergo dehydration in presence of sulfuric acid, or I can say concentrated sulfuric acid, and it used to happen according to Zetzeff rule. And Zetzeff used to say the OH group which is present on the carbon is considered as alpha carbon atom, and the immediate next carbon atom is called as beta carbon atom. So during dehydration, beta hydrogen atom will be eliminated by taking OH group and alkene will be formed. And if you have a compound like butanol 2, it is having two beta carbon atoms, so it is having two hydrogen atoms also, which is present on beta carbon atom. So during dehydration, we will be getting mixture of two kinds of alkenes, and one would be the major. In this case, we will get one alkene, which is but2-ene, is the major product, and but1-ene is the minor product. In the similar manner, when 2-methylpropane-2-ol is undergoing dehydration, you will be getting 2-methylprop-1-ene. And the ease of dehydration of alcohol is in order of 3 degree alcohol are most, then the 2 degree, and then 2 degree are more than the 1 degree alcohols. Now, oxidation of alcohols. On reaction with oxidizing agent, primary and secondary alcohols undergo dehydrogenation to form carbonyl compounds, which are aldehydes and ketones respectively. Secondary alcohol on oxidation with chromic anhydride forms ketone. If you are seeing secondary alcohol is undergoing oxidation, they will be forming ketones, and primary alcohol on oxidation, they will be give you aldehyde. When common oxidizing agent like nitric acid, potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate is used to oxidize primary alcohol on oxidation, the reaction would not stop on the formation of aldehyde. It will further oxidize the aldehyde formed and converted into carboxylic acid. And the carboxylic acid form will be having same number of carbon atoms which are there in the alcohol taken initially. Tertiary alcohols does not oxidize. They are very much give difficult situation to us to get oxidized. and oxidize on oxidation with strong oxidizing agent and high temperature, tertiary alcohol undergo the breaking of carbon to carbon single covalent bond, and they used to give us the mixture of carboxylic acid containing less number of carbon atoms than the tertiary alcohol have already. Now heating with copper. When vapors of various types of alcohols are passed over hot copper at 573 Kelvin, we observe the following reaction. Primary alcohols on oxidation in presence of copper, which is heated at 573, we will get aldehydes. Secondary alcohols, we will get ketones. Tertiary alcohols, we will be getting alkenes. So these are the products we will be getting by heating the alcohols with copper at 573 Kelvin. Now the next is the reaction of phenols. Phenol undergo electrophilic substitution reaction more readily as compared to benzene. The OH group present in phenol, or you can say present on the benzene ring, is ortho and para directing group, which used to activate the benzene ring. That is why it is more reactive than benzene. So the first reaction is halogenation of phenol. Phenol reacts with aqueous solution of bromine to give 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Chlorine also reacts in the same way. If you see the equation, 3 bromine molecule will be reacting with phenol, and we have taken its aqueous solution. 3 hydrogen atoms from 2, 4 and 6 position from the benzene ring will be out and form HBr molecules, and 3 bromo atoms will be attached to 2, 4, 6 position on phenol. If the reaction is carried out in the solvent of low polarity than water, like carbon tetrachloride or chloroform, we will get orthobromophenol and parabromophenol along with hydrogen bromide. Here, parabromophenol will be the major product. Now next is nitration of phenol. Phenol used to react with dilute nitric acid at low temperature to give you ortho and paranitrophenol. And if phenol is reacting with concentrated nitric acid, in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, it will be give you compound called as picric acid. Picric acid is 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. It is yellow colored compound which remain in a liquid state, and it is used as a laboratory reagent generally. Now sulfonation of phenol. Phenol reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid to give at room temperature orthophenol sulfuric acid, and at 373 Kelvin it will give us parasulfonic acid. On ortho position you will be seeing SO3H group, and on para position you will be seeing SO3H group in two products formed, which are orthophenol sulfonic acid and paraphenol sulfonic acid respectively. Now Riemer-Thiemann reaction. When phenol is treated with chloroform in aqueous sodium hydroxide solution followed by hydrolysis, salicyl aldehyde will be formed. How? This phenol is taken. It is reacting with chloroform in presence of aqueous and OH. First of all, this OH group will be turned up into sodium phenoxide group, and on ortho position CHCl2 group would be attached. And on further reaction with NaOH, what will happen? This CHCl2 group will be transformed into aldehyde group, and on further hydrolysis you will be getting salicyl aldehyde. If instead of chloroform carbon tetrachloride is taken, so here on ortho position the group will be coming which will be CCl3 group, and on hydrolysis we will be getting see sorry on reaction with NaOH we will be getting here COOH group on ortho position, and on hydrolysis we will be getting COOH group on ortho position instead of CHO group, and the compound would be formed called as salicylic acid. Now the next is Kolbe reaction. Kolbe reaction is another method to prepare salicylic acid. The treatment of sodium phenoxide with carbon dioxide at 398 Kelvin under pressure 6 atmosphere followed by acid hydrolysis will be getting salicylic acid, and the reaction is known as Kolbe reaction. See the reaction, sodium phenoxide will be taken. It is reacting with carbon dioxide at 398 Kelvin temperature and 6 atmospheric pressure. You will be getting on ortho position COONa group, and on further hydrolysis you will be getting salicylic acid. Now oxidation of phenol. Phenol on oxidation with chromic anhydride or sodium dichromate in presence of sulfuric acid, it will give you para-benzoquinone. And phenol oxidizes slowly, giving a dark color mixture in presence of air. The next is catalytic hydrogenation of phenol. That means we are saturating the double bond present in the benzene ring by addition of hydrogen molecules in presence of nickel catalyst at temperature 433 Kelvin. So simply, three molecules of hydrogen will be added up into the benzene ring and will be getting cyclohexanol. Last reaction of phenol is when phenol is heated with zinc dust. What will happen? Benzene will form along with the formation of zinc oxide. So this is all about the reaction of phenols. Thank you.